you know, Allyson has had to go through the program to get her parking permit with Lexington High School and Dr. Sherry Walters and all of them, and obviously partnering with Sheriff Metz. But one of the things that we found is, although it is becoming more available throughout the state, it's unfortunately because of tragedies such as Tommy Gladden up in Lugoff Elgin High School that made it mandatory, and Fort Mill High School, Beverly Bowman, and D. Christopher that unfortunately just experienced two deaths over the past 2 months.
Wow.
And so we were up there this past weekend putting 380 students through the program because of tragedy.
Yeah.
You know, so that's why partnering with Allyson and utilizing her as our platform, she's going to be able to hit the peer-to-peer, really talk about the program. And, you know, she's been through it. And Allyson, what did you think of the program?
The program had a great impact on my life. You know, I went into the program thinking I was the world's best driver, just, you know, the teenage mentality.
Yep.
I came out realizing that it's a great responsibility to be a driver and that you have to be aware.
Well, aside from the Live at 25 program, which has been very instrumental, there's pending bills in the House and Senate now for texting while driving, as well as cell phone usage. So clearly the seatbelt law in and of itself had a dramatic impact, but unfortunately, out of 188 deaths last year in the age group of 15 to 24, 118 of them were not wearing their seatbelt. That's 66% that could have been prevented. That may have changed the difference between life and death in that vehicle collision.
It's going out there and really specifying what type of car is in the best interest of our young adults, making sure that they have the safety features, from the seat belts to the safety to the GPSs that you cannot utilize as you go down the road.
I have forever, since the inception of this program, I've contended this is the most important program or anything going on for the lives of our South Carolina youths.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no question, it's now beginning to statistically prove that, as Brooke could well tell you, and there's nothing more important. And I just urge all parents and everybody to please give ardent support to Alive at 25.